Ladies and gentlemen, from one of the great sports cities in the world, Chicago, this is the moment we've been waiting for. So let's make some noise and let's get this party started. Coming to the ring first for our main event, here is the gentleman from Philadelphia, Chaz the Gentleman Witherspoon!
Chaz Witherspoon was at a car auction buying cars for his car lot when he got the call. But he said, yeah, I'm ready to go. Big chance here, chance to make some money as well. He is the second cousin of terrible Tim Witherspoon. If you recognize the name, talented heavyweight of the 1980s. Tim Witherspoon lost a split decision to Larry Holmes in 1983 when Holmes was an all-time great. Also had wins over Ronaldo Snipes, Quick Tillis, Bone Crusher Smith, Frank Bruno included. Chaz Witherspoon doesn't have wins like that, but he will get a chance of a lifetime here tonight in the heavyweight debut of the cruiserweight champion, Alexander Usyk.
Now making his entrance to the ring, the undefeated Alexander
Just seeing him stride in, you get the sense this is an elite gladiator at his peak, and you would be correct. Unified Cruiserweight Champion of the World, 2011 World Amateur Champion at Heavyweight, 2012 Olympic Gold Medalist at Heavyweight. By the way, he beat Artur Beterbiev in the quarterfinals in both of those tournaments. And now having cleaned out 200 pounds, he moves up to Heavyweight here in Chicago. Danny Sheridan has Usyk, the favorite, obviously, here against Chaz Witherspoon, a 40-1 favorite as well. Coming in, and we look to be impressed by Usyk, who is a stylish boxer, quick hands, quick feet, constant movement, and here ready to step up a full 6'3", 215 pounds.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we'll honor the two fighters with their respective national anthems. So please remain silent. First, the national anthem for Ukraine to be performed by Mr. Vasily Bondarchuk. The national anthem for the United States of America to be performed by Miss Rebecca Brunner. Gentlemen, from the windy city, Chicago, Illinois, here at the Wintrust Arena, this is the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing in the heavyweight division. Live on DAZN and Sky Sports, and it's all brought to you by Eddie Hearn from Matchroom Boxing USA and K2 Promotions Ukraine. Sponsored by William Hill, Core Premium Vodka, one of the best-selling vodkas in the world, now available in America. Coors Light, made to chill. Ingrad, and JD Sports. Sanctioned by the Illinois State Athletic Board, acting director, Nancy Eilig. Executive Manager Joel Campuzano. The three judges at ringside scoring this contest will be Al Gallardo, Jerry Jakubko, and Bill Lurch. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, veteran referee Hector Afu. So now, the officials are in place, and they are ready. The fighters are in the ring, and they are ready. Boxing fans, are you ready for the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world? Ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing burgundy with silver and officially weighing in at 242 pounds. He's the only fighter ever to win the National Gold Gloves with all knockout victories. And this USA Olympic team member now has an excellent professional record of 38 victories, 29 big wins by knockout, only 3 defeats. Born, raised, and hailing from the fighting city of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, USA, he is Chaz the Gentleman Witherspoon. And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white with green, official weight 215 pounds. He's a former amateur world champion who also captured Olympic gold. Now as a professional in the cruiserweight division, his record is a perfect one. 16 fights, 16 victories, 12 big wins by knockout. Tonight, he makes his professional heavyweight debut. He's the undefeated, undisputed cruiserweight champion of the world, Dami Gospoda, is Kiev, Ukraine, Alexander Ersi.
Okay, guys, I get the future in the dressing room. I run a clean fight, okay? This is Manny Aben. Tosh Glock, good luck.
Could be the start of big things here, Alexander Usyk. Chaz Witherspoon coming in again. He's 38. Late substitution here. Good athlete, college educated. He's fought some top fighters, but he has lost to the fighters when he has stepped up to Chris Areola, Tony Thompson, Seth Mitchell. So he's in here to try to give some work to Alexander Usyk, and it's just a matter of how spectacular can Usyk look.
Let me say this too. Usyk has fought his last 3 fights in Moscow, Latvia, and the UK. And here in Chicago, he has nearly filled this arena with his fans. That's impressive.
Usyk, again, quick hands, quick feet. He gets angles. He is perfectly balanced. He throws constant flicking jab, and Sergio just known for his pace and his work rate. Not a knockout artist, so we might not see that early, but we do expect to see his boxing skills on display.
Skills, great ring generalship. He controls the distance, the tempo. He's creative. He's like a 200-pound Vasily Lomachenko when I watch him fight.
Chaz Witherspoon, meantime, will try to show that there is a size difference and a weight difference trying to bring the load against Usyk. He is not in top condition. 242 pounds, that's the heaviest of his career. Again, he got this call quite late, but he is an experienced heavyweight and will try to give Usyk some work.
You know, I talked to Abel Sanchez today, the trainer for Murat Gassiev, who Usyk defeated to win the Undisputed Championship. He said Usyk's strengths are his ability to set traps that lead you into punches. And he's almost like Lomachenko in that way. He sets the rhythm of every fight he's in.
Yeah, he creates openings with his feet, and that's what makes him so special. He's athletic, he's creative, he sets the tempo, but it's all footwork.
A good body shot there with the left hand by Usyk. Yeah, his footwork is spectacular. And you'll see him dancing frequently too. He likes to dance in the ring. Good jab by Usyk. He's known for that. But he's got many viral videos of him just dancing in the ring, in the gym, enjoying himself. He says he lives for boxing. Boxing is his life. Long jab by Witherspoon keeps Usyk at bay. First 2 minutes of the heavyweight debut by the cruiserweight champ. It's been slow go so far. Right hand tried by Witherspoon. Well, Sergio, if you're Witherspoon, you got to feel decent about this, right? You're able to be calm and look at this man who is the fighter of the year and say, all right, I can box with this guy a little bit.
So far, so good for Witherspoon, absolutely. Usyk is coming off a career-long layoff. This is his first big step up to the heavyweight division, so maybe it's just a feel-out round for the pound-for-pound great fighter in Usyk.
I think if you're Witherspoon, though, you have to be really active in these opening rounds. Usyk is a fighter who's used to going the distance. Witherspoon is effectively getting off the couch and coming into this fight. I think he's got to make an impact early.
No, especially since Usyk's coming off an injury and a long layoff, of course. Jump on him early.
That was a torn right bicep that he tore in training. He was supposed to make his heavyweight debut in May, so his fight was called off with Carlos de Camp. So it pushed back to tonight, and round one is in the books. Our friend John Cusack is here. He's wearing his Benny the Jet jacket. And he loves kickboxing and loves boxing as well. So John here with his nephew, here to take in the boxing. And again, like most of Chicago, excited to see Alexander Usyk here in the United States and, of course, making his heavyweight debut. Sergio, your thoughts on round one, which was rather slow?
Well, Witherspoon didn't really get hit with anything like that, and Usyk, that's his first round, first 3 minutes as a heavyweight, so just a feel-out round for both of them. I expect a lot more in the second round.
Round number two here in Chicago. Oops. Brian Kenny with Sergio Mora and Chris Mannix ringside. Steve Smoger, Hall of Fame referee, is here ringside as well. Claudia Trejos with us backstage for any reports, anything that happens that's fascinating here. So far, nothing yet. Round two underway. And Alexander Usyk. Again, he is 6'3", 215. At one point, that would be big enough at heavyweight. No longer the case as he follows up with the right hand. Also, Chris Mannix, I'll put it to you that he also doesn't have a lot of punching power and doesn't sit down on his punches. He will overwhelm you with volume and angles and pick you apart, and you wonder how that will work against the elite at this division.
Yeah, he does hit you with four, five, sometimes six punch combinations, but the accuracy, I think, is where the power stems from. And I do like the 215 pounds he came in at. He didn't just blow up and go to 220, 225. He targeted that 215-pound weight, and he hit that 215-pound weight.
See him touching him to the body with the jab right after that straight left hand. Again, he's very accurate with his punches. Normally throws out a flicking jab, a double jab, but so far, Chaz Witherspoon, again, at least somewhat reminiscent of Terrible Tim Witherspoon, his second cousin. Witherspoon had a terrific jab, just a natural jab, and Witherspoon is just presenting that classic heavyweight package to Usyk right now.
Usually Usyk is able to back up his opponent with footwork, but right now Witherspoon's not falling for it. He's not falling for none of the foot feints or the creative athleticism of Usyk.
Usyk landing a left hand to the body. Usyk has been calling out Deontay Wilder. Hey, it doesn't hurt. And again, he's in line to be a WBO mandatory for Ruiz Joshua, the winner of that fight. And those two will rematch on December 7th. Again, but first, he's got to get things underway. Witherspoon with a jab. Get his feet wet here in the unlimited weight class. Usyk already with a slower work rate than we're used to seeing. No question about that. Chant is going up here in Chicago for Usyk. Intent right now to start slow, take his time, and wait for openings.
Oh, he's always been something of a slow starter. He's a very adaptive fighter. He looks at what he's seeing in the ring and adjusts accordingly. I would say that straight up the middle body shot, that's going to be there for Usyk all night.
Probing there with the left hand. Again, he can throw a lead left, but normally he likes to jab. Now you see a little bit of the footwork there, but so far Usyk really not putting the pedal to the metal. Slow first two rounds here in Usyk's debut at heavyweight.
That should.
Ниже, Чико, ниже.
Сейчас интересно. Именно заходишь.
Понял.
Куда ты заходишь, вы берете это лучше. Да, нам как-то пробиваешь, так и через эту лодку.
Хорошо.
Через три живот и голову выбиваем.
Come back with another right hand. Second top.
Round three, first two rounds, very slow for Alexander Usyk. Cruiserweight champion, fighter of the year, stepping up in heavyweight. Let's see if he starts to slap it into another gear, and it looks like he does right there. Again, the right jab coming right up. Again, he has not fought in 11 months. Had a ruptured right bicep in training after he beat Tony Bellew in Manchester in November. So again, he hasn't fought in nearly a year. He is looking at a different package in front of him, Sergio Mora. And that is a big, full-size man at 6'4", 242.
Yeah, Witherspoon hasn't really given too much openings. And right now, the most effective punch that Usyk has landed has been a straight left to the midsection of Witherspoon.
And now he starts to pick it up.
That's two straight left hands right up the middle, the kind of shots we saw him knock Tony Bellew out with several months ago.
Claudia Trejos was in the corner for the Witherspoon camp. Claudia, what are we hearing? Claudia, thank you. Yeah, no, absolutely. If you're Tommy Brooks, veteran trainer, he's been in there with so many fighters over the last few decades, you've got to be thrilled. It's a slow pace. Your man is conserving his energy, which he's going to have to. You know, if you're looking to win rounds or win the fight, look, I don't know what you do there, but you're just looking for a good outing. And so far, the pace has to meet your liking, at the very least. Usyk now backs up Witherspoon to the ropes with a jab and a jab to the body.
Yeah, waiting. Feels like a bad strategy to me.
And the left hand straight up. Yeah, but I don't know, can Witherspoon bum rush Usyk, Chris?
Saw him do it against Seth Mitchell in that first round of that fight back in 2012, and he was effective in spurts, but if you're looking for his chances of winning, I think it's that.
Usyk now starting to get a little bit of a rhythm, moving in and out. This is what he's known for, the constant footwork, jabs coming up, that one missed, was blocked by Witherspoon. But we're used to seeing a constant work rate. And Usyk just going to town, and he's not that much bigger. Again, he's 215 pounds weighing in. The cruiserweight weight limit is 200, so he's put on a little bit of weight as he jumps in there with the left hand to the body.
That's been the effective punch for Usyk right there, straight left hand. Now he's getting more angles, moving around the ring, and that's making it more difficult for Witherspoon, because Witherspoon doesn't want to have to chase the more athletic and agile Usyk.
Hard jab there by Usyk. And trying to give Witherspoon a bit of a blinder. Witherspoon again for his limitations. And there's both of those punches landing. For his limitations, he is able to stay calm and see punches well. But now Usyk, who keeps throwing his hands down as if to get loose, fires off a left hand at the bell, and that lands. Usyk's wife, Katya, enjoying the action here.
Да. Протянулась, и снова пробил.
Here are the two cleanest punches, straight left hand, back to back, landed by Usyk. Witherspoon landed, took him well.
One thing that we've seen here, and it might be a small thing, but Usyk keeps throwing his hands down, Sergio. I don't know, as if to loosen up his own shoulders and get relaxed or something, or I don't know if his hands hurt or what it is.
He's coming off a career-long layoff, maybe just shaking off the rust, and maybe that's why we're seeing a little bit of the first two rounds. He's getting the cobwebs out.
Yeah, that's what it seems like to me, too. And usually that means that, you know, I can't get my shoulders loose. I've got to relax. Or unless he's in pain somewhat, I don't think he is. But again, he is doing that little tell as if to say, you know, relax. Let me get my hands down. Let me get my shoulders loose.
That's what happens when you're inactive so long, especially when you're as active
there
as
Usyk was. You see that with the left hand. Again, he's just kind of firing it out there. Again, the torn bicep was in his right bicep. So it's not that, but he is still trying to get looser here in the ring in round four. So a bit of an uncharacteristic start, I think it's fair to say, for Usyk, even though he is moving up in weight and facing a much bigger man. Is that fair?
That's fair.
Now you see the power punch has landed through three rounds. I mean, it's not close, according to CompuBox. Witherspoon is throwing more, but it's Usyk who is much more accurate. Again, we didn't expect to see Usyk severely tested in this fight, especially after Tyrone Spong failed his drug test and Witherspoon was a last-minute replacement. But we did expect to see a high work rate from Usyk. Now Usyk goes to work. He's got Witherspoon in the corner. Witherspoon able to walk out.
Now Witherspoon got his attention with that quick counter. Backed Usyk up just for a split second.
Usyk firing that left hand over the top. Again, he's got a very educated jab, usually extremely active with it, and that left hand fires off right off the jab. It comes off right away. There's no hesitation. Final minute of the fourth round, Usyk starts to close the gap.
Left hand to the body of Witherspoon has been the best punch that I think Usyk has been landing. I would just encourage him to keep throwing that left hand downstairs.
I'm just saying, for a 38-year-old guy who's not fought the top tier in this weight division in years, Witherspoon is not being overwhelmed. Not yet. Usyk able to get away from that Witherspoon right hand. Witherspoon trying to throw a meaningful shot. Good jab by Usyk. Witherspoon starts to open up the attack just a bit. Usyk steps in, able to land his combination.
Way! How you feel? Huh? Okay, look, you let him get in range and you're just looking at it. You gotta fire something, baby.
Here we're gonna see Usyk finally let go of some combinations right here. Nothing really landed cleanly on Witherspoon, but it's still mental pressure by Usyk on Witherspoon. Sometimes that's just gonna be enough to fluster your opponent to open up the openings and land the big shots.
And there was that counter I was talking about that just backed Usyk up enough to keep him from continuing that flurry.
Round five scheduled for 12. Chris Mannix giving all four rounds to Alexander Usyk. Tommy Brooks in Witherspoon's corner was saying, you've got to get closer to land. He asked Witherspoon, how are you doing? He said, I'm all right. Not the most resounding answer. He's done better than we expected, but I wonder how much he has in the tank. Again, boxing Usyk takes an awful lot of energy, even though he's off to the slow start that we've seen.
And that's why I didn't think that he should necessarily go straight Peter McNeely on Mike Tyson, but being more aggressive in the early rounds when you're fighting a supremely conditioned athlete like Usyk, I thought would have been a strategy that may have had some semblance of being successful.
And for you kids out there, Peter McNeely bum-rushed Tyson.
You covered that fight, didn't you?
It was a round.
Sergio was on the undercard.
It's not that. It's actually, it doesn't feel that long ago. By the way, Usyk is just throwing 24 jabs per round. He averages 42 per round, and that's at least in his last seven fights. Those are championship fights at the cruiserweight level. So we expected to see Usyk overwhelm Witherspoon, put the pedal to the metal. We haven't seen it as of yet. What would you advise, Sergio? What do you think he should do here?
That left hand to the body right there. That's been the most effective punch that Usyk's been landing. And if nothing's really opening up, Witherspoon's not really giving him much right now. The only punch that's been landing, can he keep throwing that punch downstairs? Like that.
And he follows up with the jab to the head. Again, that's a kind of a subtle move that he does. Look at how fast that is. Just the left hand right off the jab. He is already throwing that left hand as the jab is landing. This crowd wants to see action. Jab to the body for Usyk.
I would keep stabbing Witherspoon downstairs, because once he does drop those elbows and drop those arms and the guard, then Usyk could come around with the speed and he's gonna land something upstairs.
Tripling up on the jab as he gets inside, but doesn't yield much result. Well, that's a good hard jab by Usyk.
Usyk tried to get an angle right there on Witherspoon. He should have thrown a punch first before he tried to get that angle on the side.
Usyk does make you work. He puts pressure on you. Chaz Witherspoon, again, he's 38. He's the heaviest of his career. This will wear him down. That was a good sharp jab as well. And that is a quick lead left by Usyk. Again, he is not like getting full leverage, but he is just popping out straight punches.
Here we're gonna see Usyk throw some punches. Nothing really landed effectively or on the money or on the button, but it did get to back up the bigger man in Witherspoon. And big men like that, especially inactive big men like that, hate moving backwards. They don't train for that, and their legs aren't accustomed for that.
Round six, the heavyweight debut of Alexander Usyk, who looks like he's still trying to loosen up. I am peering in to Witherspoon's corner between rounds, Sergio, and he looks like, look, he's doing the professional thing. He's trying to manage his energy, but he looks gassed in between rounds. He's not giving it away in the round, but between rounds, he is sucking in, you know, big gulps of air. And I wonder how much he's got in the tank.
And that's why Usyk should continue pressing him back, because big men like Witherspoon aren't accustomed to going back like that. Even though nothing clean is landing, it's forcing him to use his legs and going in an angle in a direction he's not accustomed to for a big man.
You know, to that effect, again, it's not as if he's being outclassed. He tries an uppercut. He's probably losing every round. Chris, I think that's what you're saying, right?
I damn, yeah. He is losing every round, pretty convincingly.
But we want to see more, don't we?
From Usyk, of course, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, you mentioned the output with the jab. That's a little bit different than what we've seen at cruiserweight.
Good hard body shot. Usyk now moving through, but then backs away. All right, how about that?
Not sure what that was about. It looked like he was hurt in the corner. Witherspoon, Usyk let him out.
What about that, Sergio?
Well, he noticed that Witherspoon wasn't really hurt with nothing. He was just going back. He wasn't. Witherspoon does have fast hands for a big guy. He's just looking to counter Usyk in between, and Usyk didn't really think he landed anything.
Yeah, look, Usyk drove him back. I'll give it to Usyk. His boxing IQ is sky high. So I respect that, but that was a bit of a surprise where you had the man in the corner and he just opted to back away and re-engage in the center of the ring. That's where we are right now, halfway through round six. Maybe he wants to go rounds.
shake off the inactivity. It's possible. It's the longest layoff for Usyk. But right now, you see that Witherspoon wants to come forward. I think going back, backing up is Usyk's point.
Claudia Trejos is in Usyk's corner. Claudia. Got him hurt right now. Usyk backs him up. Claudia, thank you so much. Igas Klimas, manager as well for Usyk. And now some success. Usyk goes to work. This might not be far away.
Referee taking a long look right now.
Yeah, Hector Alfudes is taking a long look. Again, Witherspoon is trying to keep his comportment, but he is very tired already. Last minute sub, Usyk goes to work. And every time he slaps it into a higher gear, it looks like he could end it. At least it did there. Usyk patient, but looked like he was on the verge of a stoppage.
Hey, yo, man. Hey, Chad, you let this get away from you, man. Take a deep breath, let it out slow. What? Take a deep breath, let it out slow. Hey, listen, man. When you're on the ropes, you gotta fire back.
Here we see Usyk back up Witherspoon against the ropes. Witherspoon looks like he's getting a little fatigued and tired, and it's those left hands to the gut that have been doing it right there. Left uppercut, he came around the guard of Witherspoon. I don't know how much longer Witherspoon will be able to withstand this attack from different angles of Usyk.
A patient performance so far by Alexander Usyk. I don't know if he's putting the heavyweight division on notice, but he is taking his time, trying to get loose. Again, dealing with a different frame, a different size fighter in front of him. Looked like he was on the verge of stopping Witherspoon there in round six. When he is throwing, Chris Mannix, he's very impressive.
He's impressive, he's accurate, and he's hurting Witherspoon with those shots. And Sergio, you've heard the phrase in boxing, you don't get paid extra for overtime. I do think watching this fight that Usyk, who's coming off the longest layoff of his career, may want to go a few rounds, shake some of that rust off, because there have been multiple times it looked like if he cornered Witherspoon and flurried, he could have at least had the referee step in to stop the fight.
That might be the case when you're that gifted as Usyk is, and you've been off the longest layoff in your career. Then, yeah, if you feel comfortable in there and you're shaking off the rust, absolutely.
I mean, look at the difference here in the punches landed through six rounds. Wow, 105 to 19. Usyk landing 26 punches in that sixth round. That was the best of the night. So look, he's winning the fight, winning easily. It's just a matter of, this is a guy calling out the heavyweight champions. He's only 215 pounds. Is he going to create a mandate, or could he get one of those fights? And if he did get one of those fights, what would he do? We don't know. We thought it would be fascinating. Still kind of think that. But we expect him to put Chaz Witherspoon away. I think that's fair to say. Witherspoon backed into the corner after that left hand. Usyk going to work. He's really not let his hands go too often in this fight. Round seven. Scheduled for 12, and he is literally, Usyk is trying to shake the rust off. He's shaking out his hands and his elbows a few times. That's a hard jab as he steps in. And that's Witherspoon in the corner.
The best shots that I've seen Usyk land have been straight lefts and rights to the body. And that's been wearing down Witherspoon.
We just also thought that he would just have such a speed advantage, a hand speed advantage, that he would be able to strafe any heavyweight he got in there with. And that hasn't quite occurred against Witherspoon, although clearly he's outlanding Witherspoon by a wide, wide margin.
He's outclassing and outpunching Witherspoon, but yeah, I agree with you, BK. It's not the heavyweight that we expected. We expected more power to try to hurt Witherspoon here.
Now the straight left hands coming in. The crowd's going wild, trying to urge their man on. He's a man with over 330 amateur wins, sometimes content just to win, but that hurt Witherspoon, and he goes back into the corner. Hector Apu is taking a good long look. You see how close he's getting. Witherspoon tries to walk out of the corner and fight his way out. final seconds. Does Usyk want a stoppage? And how much does he want it? Hey, Steve Smoker, if you're in the ring right now, how close would you be? We see the blood in Witherspoon's mouth. Would you be close to stopping this or no?
No. Okay. Chaz has some life left. He's been doing a great job, and he's taking a shot. He is tiring, though.
Steve, thank you. And look, that is the look. You're like, hey, wait a second. Now, ref is in the corner with Witherspoon right now. Let's listen in. Yeah, no, that's it. Yeah, Chaz Witherspoon is gassed. This fight is over. Chaz Witherspoon just did not have the energy to continue on. He took the fight on short notice. He tried to put in a professional effort. He did what he could, but that's it. And I'll tell you what, the Chicago fans love Usyk. A stoppage for Usyk. It was a patient performance. He showed the skill. It wasn't quite electrifying, but he got the job done.
It wasn't electrifying, but I think Witherspoon was knocked out by fatigue and Usyk's athleticism, of course, but Witherspoon was spent. As you can see how he just collapsed in the corner, and anytime a fighter puts his arms on the ropes like that, he is tired, fatigued, and he wants out.
Again, between each round, as you see the fighters embrace. Mutual respect there, professional respect, but in between rounds, even before it was evident that he was tired during the rounds, he was gassed in between. Katia Usyk is happy with the result. The Chicago fans love their man. Cruiserweight champion of the world moving up. Maybe he's got work to do, but an easy victory here for Usyk tonight in Chicago. Well, it'll be fascinating, Sergio, to see one of the big men take on Usyk. But here he was able to be patient and know that the win was well within reach at all times.
It was within reach. I'm curious to see what he grades this performance. He didn't take the chances that I thought he was going to take, but when he did, he was very successful with it. But Witherspoon was looking for the right counters. I don't know if he respected Usyk's power. That's something that I would like. Hopefully Chris Mannix could ask him. But Witherspoon, I think he got knocked out by fatigue just as much as Usyk's punches.
Oh, no question. But also, in highlight form, if we're looking at this, you say, wow, Usyk looks great. What are they even talking about? Well, in real time, it was slow. It was methodical. When the man lets his hands go, look, that's a thing of beauty. Usyk is beautifully balanced, active. The jab is outstanding. And the left hand is a good power shot. This was the end of the round. And it was up to Witherspoon himself if he wanted to continue. And the referee was there to hear Witherspoon basically say, look, fellas, that was it. That's all I got. Let's go to Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of round 7, Chaz Witherspoon's corner informs the referee he is unable to continue. The winner by TKO victory, the official time comes at the end of that 7th round. Still undefeated, he is. From Ukraine, and he is Oleksandr Usyk.
TKO 7 for Usyk.